What's going on, everyone? iLoot Games here, back with another video, and in this video I wanted to put out this quick update to go over the patch notes because they did just spring a patch on us that was people were just begging for this to happen. And if you weren't one of those people, let me know down in the comments what you think now that it has happened. And let's just go ahead and jump into what these changes are, because they reverted the time to kill, which is a big deal for a lot of people. There was a lot of uproar in the community, so I'll go ahead and get started here. Hi everyone, this is Jason McCord, design director on Apex Legends. In Season 6, we made a few big changes to the way our armor works. First, all armor became Evo armor. Second, all armor values were reduced by 25. After letting the change simmer for a few weeks, we've analyzed some data and collected player feedback enough to make a decision. We are going to revert the armor values back to pre-season 6 values. This change is happening today across all platforms. We are keeping the all Evo armor change. Okay, so just a quick pause there for those who do not understand. Red armor is no longer going to be 100 health. It's going to be 125. Purple armor is once again going to be 100. And white armor is going to be 50. And blue armor is going to be 75. Gold armor, by the way, is also back to 100. So gold armor is actually pretty useful now, once again, where it wasn't before. Evil armor was just way preferred. I'd like to take this opportunity to explain why we made that change and why we are reverting it. From the start of Apex Legends development, one of our core pillars was that getting the drop on someone should give those players a significant advantage. We aim to promote strategy in battlefield positioning and map control. When these tactics were executed well, but a team still outplayed you because of mechanical skill, this felt very bad. In Season 1 through 5, we felt this balance was achieved pretty well. However, with the introduction of Evo armor change, we saw in our internal playtest that players were achieving red armor 125 shields more often, and more players were fighting at a total of 225 health. This started to swing the battles more than we liked, and good players were able to outplay teams more consistently, even if the enemy had worked for a much better position. By lowering the armor values, we felt we had adjusted for the red armor availability more than anything else. Now, it's important to note that we play tested this for months internally. For those play tests, feedback was positive, but we are a small group of people compared to the millions that play Apex Legends every day. The skill levels in our team are varied, and big balance changes are really only going to be vetted when we get feedback from all of you. We are always striving to improve the experience in Apex Legends. Sometimes these changes can be more experimental. We're not always going to get things right, but it's important for us to listen and correct things when we don't. I can't promise you that we won't try experimental changes again. In fact, I will promise you that we will change the game in order to keep it fresh and interesting as the years go on. I hope that this patch proves that we are thinking deeply about our decisions, but most importantly, listening to our players. Besides the armor changes, we have addressed a number of issues that we are listing below. Thanks for reading, and I'll see you out there. The number one dev, Jason McCord, design director. So before I get into the fixes, I just want you guys to know that what that results in. So their whole reasoning for the lowering the TTK was actually to close the skill gap, which is what a lot of top players started to complain about. They're saying, you know, it doesn't make sense that you're lowering the skill gap when we've worked so hard to increase our skill level. This is kind of the same argument you get when everyone talks about SBMM. You know, the SBMM punishes those who worked harder to get better skill levels, because then they just play against the hardest people and makes the game less fun. So I'm interested in knowing what you guys think about that, now that they reveal that their whole point of lowering the shield health was really to balance the skill gap. I think that's really interesting to hear. So let's go ahead and go over these errors glitches that they fixed. In general, they fixed server crashes, okay? Made adjustments to the appearance of several holo sprays and removed an inappropriate caustic voice line. Now, that caustic voice line is actually when caustic would call crypto a rat. And now in some cultures, this is very offensive. And so that's why they removed that one. So I know a lot of people were wondering about that. If you've already read the patch notes, you were probably wondering. Now you know. Audio, fix an issue with audio not playing when shooting the Devotion or Volt. And in fact, today on stream, for like the first time, I heard what the Devo sound like. It's pretty crazy. Fix an issue where Crypto's drone and caustic gas would play to the whole server. Fix marking crafting replicators from the ship playing a Let's Go Here voice ping. That was very annoying and no longer does that. So you don't have to like look around thinking your team actually pinged a location when they didn't. Replicators, fix an issue with Evo shields that require exactly 100 damage, not evolving when crafting the 100 points. So I've had this happen When I needed exactly 100 damage, it put my shield to need 0 damage and did not evolve my shield. Very strange. But they fixed that. Another thing to note about the replicators, guys, as I was playing with controller players today, they said that the bind to use the replicator has changed. So if you go into the replicator and you're trying to craft something and you're like, why isn't it working? Look at the bind. It looks like it's changed, apparently, at least for these two guys it did. Fixed an issue with a ninja controller configuration not being able to use replicators. Okay, so that's probably part of it. Fixed an issue with not being able to revive a teammate when they are downed while using a replicator. I did hear big complaints about this issue from pros, and they actually wanted to delay the tournaments that were coming up because of all the bugs. So this is definitely a much needed patch. Gibraltar fixed an issue with dome shield on Sheila, allowing a player to shoot through the dome shield. That's kind of crazy. Rampart fixed an issue with the no mercy finisher spamming boom to the entire server. Fixed an issue with amped cover walls requiring more hits from heirlooms than from normal melee to be destroyed. Fixed a server crash when Sheila is destroyed while someone is using it. It's interesting that it doesn't look like they fixed the glitch to get into the vault using Sheila. I'm kind of surprised about that one. Crypto fixed an issue with hack not detecting players on Sheila. Wraith fixed an issue with the portal disappearing upon Wraith's death. This is very annoying. I had this happen to me a couple times. Fixed a crash with Wraith's portal interacting with World's Edge Geyser. So those who are crashing the server, you can no longer do that. Fixed an error when Wraith's portal is too close to a replicator and the player interacts with the replicator. And then Loba fixed an issue that caused Loba's teleport to fail in certain areas. Her teleport is just an issue for some reason. I don't understand why, but I don't know how you... Those of you that are Loba mains, how do you do it? She is just... She's so bad. I'm sorry. But that's it for the patch notes. I want to know what you guys think. We should be having an event come up soon. I will be sharing details on the event. It should be either... It's either going to be next Tuesday or it's going to be the following Tuesday. I think probably next Tuesday. We've had the normal amount of time that they put between events. And then there a lot of rumors going around about crossplay. There has been code added to the game files that show crossplay is progressing, and they have a lot more stuff in the game for it. Now the question is, are we actually going to get crossplay this month? Now there is no official announcement. I have not even seen a dev even hint at it or tease anything, nothing at all. So we'll just keep our fingers crossed. It would be nice if we do get it this month, and the rumors have been saying somewhere mid-month this month, so we'll see. And that's gonna be it for me, guys. I hope you enjoy. I will be on stream later today and all month to celebrate September, which is actually where they've lowered the cost on Twitch to subscribe to someone. If you're a first-time subscriber, make sure you subscribe on a computer, not from your phone, to get the discount. To celebrate, I'm giving away 1,000 Apex coins every day on stream. So if you want to be a part of that, if you want to get some Apex coins, that's the place to be. I will see you there and catch you next time, guys.